So how come Sandy and I are here in Rockport, Massachusetts? The story coming up next. Hi, everybody. Bob Sokoler along with
Sandy Sokoler.
And we are in Rockport, Massachusetts. You can tell it's just beautiful scenery here. We are at the where the ocean meets Rockport, and it's just gorgeous. More about our trip while we're here in just a moment. First, let's talk about what's happening with regard to real estate, both in Louisville and southern Indiana. The absorption rate for the Louisville area is at a 2.96 month supply, well below last year's level of a 3.48 month supply. What does that mean? Well, the absorption rate boils down to if we turned off the supply of homes coming onto the market, how long would it take for existing homes to be bought or sold? Anything less than a 5 month supply is said to be a seller's market. So if the market's so hot, why were the number of homes sold last month down 5.5%? Well, take a look at the number of homes actually on the market. It's down 9.7%. Not enough inventory to go around. The reason supply is short is because some builders can't keep up with demand. But that's just part of the problem. There are more first-time home buyers looking for homes, and existing home sellers don't want to move. Why? According to Mark Fleming, who's the chief economist over at First American, existing homeowners are refusing to list their homes for sale over concerns about finding a home to buy. It's a critical driver of supply constraint. The top reason for lack of inventory of homes both in Louisville and nationwide is, first of all, sellers are afraid that they will not be able to find another home, so they won't put their home on the market. Also, first-time buyer demand is absorbing a large share of available homes. Some sellers don't want to move because their existing mortgage rate is lower than the current rate available, or a seller has insufficient or negative equity to sell. And finally, foreign buyer demand is absorbing a large share of available homes. So we expect the market in Louisville and southern Indiana to be hot throughout the rest of the year. Interest rates, we expect maybe tick up a little bit, Sam?
Maybe a little bit, but not much right now. I think we're pretty steady for the next 60 days.
In case you don't know, Sandy is a mortgage lender for the past 40 years, and she's with Century Mortgage for some time now, so she knows what she's talking about. All right, the reason we're driving up the coast of Maine is because of Sandy's birthday. Yes, it's Sandy's birthday. So I said, okay, what would you like to do? And you said,
I want to go to Acadia State Park in Maine. Okay. Stay at the Bar Harbor Inn.
That's where we're heading. We're taking you along. Right now we've stopped at a little town just off of Route 1A where they've got a lot of water, obviously.
And white sharks.
Oh, and white sharks. You're right. Yeah. So we're getting out of here. We'll take you along for the ride, and we're in search of the best place for lobster. Our excursion actually started in Boston, where we took a tour from a boat of the harbor of Boston. A lot of history here, and it was a beautiful day to go for a boat ride. We also took a city tour through the city, looking at some of the sights and smells of Boston, then up the coast and searching for lobster. There was some beautiful scenery along the way. And in each town that we stopped in, we tasted lobster, trying to see if one place was better than the other. We hopped on the highway to head up to Bar Harbor, and look at this.
Okay, this is pretty impressive. The lobster roll, that is incredible.
From McDonald's.
McDonald's, right?
Right.
Whoa, baby, and not bad.
Yeah, okay.
And we're not kidding. Seriously, lobster rolls served at McDonald's, and they weren't bad compared to some of the others we tasted. We made it up to Bar Harbor and then into Arcadia National Park, and what a gorgeous place to spend some time. Some great views, lots of things to see, stop, and enjoy. And we also took in a sunset tour by boat. If you head up to Bar Harbor, I've got to tell you, this is a must-do. We headed back down the coast towards Kennebunkport, which was another amazing trip, and we found this place in Kennebunkport, the Clam Shack. It really is a shack, but you can tell by the length of the line, they're doing something right. Prices are incredible, and the food is very tasty. You want to order one of everything when you come to the window. If you love lobster, this is the place to come. Again, it's the Clam Shack. in Kennebunkport, not only for lobster, but also fried clams. Really, it was unbelievable. Here's a collection of some of the pictures we took along the way. If you are planning a vacation, you might want to consider taking a tour up the coast of Maine and stopping in places like Kennebunkport or Bar Harbor. The scenery is spectacular. The amount of time you spend enjoying life is so limited. Take this tour. Oh yeah, and don't forget to stop and sample the lobster along the way. As for the best lobster, well, we came to a conclusion after eating a lot of it.
Bottom line, it's all about price. The taste is pretty much the same. The crowds here are amazing, and what you'll find, quite frankly, is during rush hour or during lunch and dinner, there are jam-packed lines. But if you come off hour, you can see now the lines are pretty much quieted down. Right?
Right.
Yep. Okay, remember, if you're looking for real estate, I'm here to help you day and night, and you can reach me anytime, whether you're a buyer or a seller, 502-376-5483. We've got 20 agents ready to help you as well if you're a buyer. Give me a call. I'm Bob Sokoler along with Sandy Sokoler, Sokoler Medley Team, RE/MAX Properties.